Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this Photoshop tutorial, I will show you how to make paper cutout layer art, totally in Photoshop, based on the popular Firenze palette in the Adobe Theme Colors. You can follow my gradient map procedure to create other gradient maps based on your favorite Adobe Theme color palette. To begin, open up a new canvas in Photoshop. Name it Paper Cut. Use a width of 4269 pixels and a height of 2400 pixels with a resolution of 300 pixels per inch. Make the background white. Press D to set the default black foreground and white background. Turn off the lock on the background layer and name the layer Design. Right-click the layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Press Filter, Render, Clouds from the menu. Then choose Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur from the Filters menu. Make the blur exactly 100 pixels. Now we will posterize the image with 14 color values. Choose Images, Adjustments, Posterize. We will need to choose 40 levels to get 14 values. Double-click on the clouds layer to make random changes until you find a design that you like. The resulting image could use some contrast, so add a levels adjustment layer. Bring the two outside input sliders in towards the center as demonstrated. Click the Clip To icon to clip it to the design layer. Check that you have 14 distinct color values. Here I have numbered them. Now with the levels adjustment layer still active, press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, plus E to make a composite layer. Name it Work. Turn off the eyes of the levels layer and the design layer. Make sure your work layer is active. Next, we will be making 14 layers, one for each of the 14 values of gray on the design. I've found the best way to make the layers is with the magic wand tool. Set to a tolerance of 1, anti-alias not checked, and contiguous not checked. Do not zoom in, as you may miss some areas. Sample the darkest black. Press Ctrl-J to duplicate the selection. Press Alt or Option plus the left bracket key to bring the active layer back to the work layer. Your cursor should still remain on the layer you just copied. Now follow the same procedure for the next layer. Move your cursor over the next lightest gray and click it. Press Ctrl-J to duplicate the selection. Press Alt or Option plus the left bracket key to bring the active layer back to the work layer. Continue the same procedure until you reach the brightest white color. I've sped up the video to save time. It took me a little over a minute to make all 14 layers. Finally, zoom in to make the last two bright layers. Layer 13, then layer 14. We now have 14 layers. Now I'll turn off the work layer. If you missed any shapes, they will show up as transparent. Next, we will make two layer groups. One for shapes and one for drop shadows. Select the last layer. Then hold down the Shift key while selecting layer 1. All 14 layers will be selected. Right-click and choose Group from Layers. Name the group Shapes 1. Now right-click on the Shapes group and choose Duplicate Group. Name the duplicate Drop Shadow. Temporarily turn off the Eye of the Shapes group. Zoom in to see what's happening better. Next, click the arrow next to the Drop Shadow group to expand it to show the layers inside. Select a layer. I chose layer 6 because it is near the middle. Add a drop shadow layer style to it. Set to Blend, Multiply, Color, Black. Opacity 100%. Angle 90 degrees. Distance 6 pixels. Spread 7%. Size 8 pixels. Contour linear. Anti-alias checked. Press OK to accept. Important. Move the fill slider to 0. Now only the drop shadow will be visible for layer 6. Right-click the layer and choose Copy Layer Style. Select the last layer. Then hold down the Shift key while selecting Layer 1. All 14 layers will be selected. Right-click and choose Paste Layer Style. Now only the drop shadow is showing for all the shapes. Later we will need to place this group above the color gradient map in order for the drop shadows to show up properly. Choose the drop shadow group and click the arrow next to it to collapse the group so that the layers inside are hidden. Move down to the shapes layer and turn on its eye. We are now ready to add colors. Press Ctrl plus 0 to fit to screen. If your swatches panel is not open, open it by choosing Window, Swatches. Open the Adobe Color Themes by choosing Window, Extensions, Adobe Color Themes. Click the Explore tab if it's not already active. Then choose the most popular option. Then in the Time option box next to it, choose All. The most popular color palettes will appear. For this tutorial, we will use the Firenze palette. Click the three dots drop down below the Firenze palette. Then choose Edit This Theme. Click the Sliders option. Select each color and jot down the hex value and the HSB values. HSB stands for Hue, Saturation, and Brightness. For example, for green, I used hex value 468966 and HSB values 149, 49, and 54. Continue jotting down these values for each of the other four colors. Your notes should look something like this chart. I've ordered the colors from dark to light in the last column. Those colors with the lowest brightness come first. When two colors have the same brightness, I use the one with the largest saturation. Finally, click Add to Swatches, and the Firenze palette will be added to your swatches. Close the Color Themes panel. Now to make a gradient map based on the Firenze palette. The Shapes layer should be active. Add a Gradient Map Adjustment layer. Choose the Black-White Gradient. Click on the gradient strip. Our first stop is black. Click below the strip at about 32% to add another stop. Change the location to 32%. According to the chart, green is the darkest color. Click the color box. You can sample the green in the swatches panel to get the color. Now click below the strip at about 47%. To add another stop. Change the location to 47%. Red is the next darkest color. click the color box. You can sample the red in the swatches panel. Now click below the strip at about 60% to add another stop. Change the location to 60%. Rust is the next darkest color. Click the color box. You can sample the rust in the swatches panel. Now click below the strip at about 75% to add another stop. Change the location to 75%. Gold is the next darkest color. Click the color box. You can sample the gold in the swatches panel. Now click the end stop. Yellow is the last color. Click the color box and sample the yellow in the swatches panel. Now in the name box, make the name My Firenze. Then click the new button and the gradient will be added to the end of your gradients presets. You also may want to click the save button and save it. Close the gradient map panels. Next, to fix the image fading at the borders. Select the Drop Shadow Group layer. Press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, plus E to make a composite layer. Open the Crop tool. Set the original ratio preset. While holding down the Alt plus Shift keys, drag on the corner until the selection is beyond the faded part of the border. Then let go. Press Enter or the big check mark to accept. Here are some other possibilities. Thanks for watching.